Hi everyone, welcome to Enterprise Manager Product Training Series. This recording presents product demonstration of Oracle Real User Experience Insight. My name is Yutaka Takatsu. I am one of the product managers in Enterprise Manager Product Management team. So Real User Experience Insight, or RUEI in short, is an Enterprise Manager family product. And this is a passive monitoring tool and captures all the end user activities in your application. So it allows you to see what the users are doing in your application and monitors the performance from the end user perspectives. So let's start from knowing what questions RUEI can answer. At the left-hand side of the screen, we have is an internal business application. And there is an IT administrator who manages the application. And say there was a page error. So users of this application could not load a page. They called up the administrator about this problem. However, the administrator could not reproduce the problem in his end. So he is wondering what exactly was the error which the users were seeing. Another example. Now we have an online shopping website that is publicly open through the internet. And there is a business application owner wondering, how many customers actually came to my store in the last 24 hours and what percentage of them actually purchased my product? So these are the questions that RUEI can answer. An IT administrator can see the full session report of what exactly happened during the error time. He can further diagnose the issue using JVM diagnostics feature in Enterprise Manager and drill down to the root cause. And business application owner can see the traffic statistics and based on the KPI threshold, he can raise an alert and receive email notification. So this is a high-level introduction on what questions RUEI can answer. Next, let's see this in the actual product. So what I have here is Enterprise Manager 13.4 open my screen, and here is the page that shows RUEI monitoring an application. And this is a business applications which we use for demo purpose, but the monitoring capabilities which RUEI provides are generic to any application. So either that is a homegrown or package application that you are to monitor with RUEI, what you see in this demo is generally applicable. So you can expect a similar experience regardless of the types of applications. So what we can see in this dashboard, there is a top user section at the lower left side of the screen. So here I have five users with each having 120 to 170 sessions in the last 2 hours. And this table also has average page load time and also the total percentage of violations for each user. And violations in RUEI terminology is basically the alerts. So this can be an application side issue such as server error or network failure. Or it can be an issue based on the user experience, such as when the user aborted the page load or when they received content notifications. So those are considered as violations and going to show up here. And at the upper side of the screen, there is key performance indicator section. So there are three KPI metrics configured for this application, and currently two of them are showing threshold violations. The first metric is online store P95. So this is a metric that monitors page load time in 95 percentile. So what this is measuring is the page load time, but excluding the spikes or unusual page load time. The second metric here is search page load time greater than 6 seconds. So this is a metric that alerts me when there are a certain number of page hits that are having page load time going beyond 6 seconds. And the third metric here is completed flows late. So this measures the percentage of user flow completion and reports violations if the percentage of the user abort exceeds the threshold value. And the KPI is a metric alerting mechanism in RUEI. So you can set threshold to raise an alert in Enterprise Manager's incident management framework. And that is what you see in the incident section, which you see at the upper left side of the screen. And there are two incidents raised in the past 2 hours, and that is likely coming from the KPI violations that you see in adjacent KPI section. And this dashboard is currently showing the data for the last 2 hours of the activities went on with this particular application. But you can change the time range to show a longer period, such as 24 hours or 1 week, or you can show the historical data. So you can say, how was the performance of my server a week ago from 9 a.m. to 10 a.m., for example. Also, it takes 5 minutes for RUEI to aggregate data and show it up to the UI, but you can configure the data collection frequency on your preference. You can also see where the users are coming from. So that is the map view showing at the lower right-hand side of the screen. And I can see most of the users accessing my application from US, but I also see some users are coming from the Europe as well. And I can drill down to see the bigger map of Europe. So now I can see we had user access from Spain and Sweden. I'm not sure which country this is in the central part of Europe, but I can hover my mouse and see the tooltip. So this is Hungary, and we had 864 page views from here. And I can actually further narrow down to see which regions they are coming from within the country. So it looks like the users are in the central part of the country, and that is the city of Budapest. And in the center of the screen, at the lower side, there is a multi-level pie chart. This is the usage and violation overview section. And this image is the presentation of all the pages that are accessed in the last 2 hours. So the center of the circle is application layer, which is the wine cellar application that consists 100% of the page views. So I have 11,550 page views in total, and 2,274 are having some kind of violations. I can see the breakdown in the table view, which is showing in the right-hand side of the same section. And the area next to it is the page groups. Here is the online store that consists most of the page views, and the outer layer shows the pages. Here I clicked the wine search, which has the largest number of clicks. And as I click the chart, table view also gets updated. So this page has 1,175 application side violations and also 104 user side violations. And I can also see 3 server errors. And I can further drill down to see the instance level details by clicking the metrics link. Here I can see the access details for this specific page, which is the wine search. So looking at this first row, user ID is NGUser27. Here is the time accessed, and here is how long it took, which is 90 seconds. And the list is sorted by the time bar column, so this seems to be the slowest page during the last 2 hours. And I see the client abort, which means the user did not wait to complete the page load, which makes sense because it was taking 19 seconds. And I have so many of them here with a similar experience, so something was causing the slowdown of this page. And the search section has filters already pre-configured, but you can add other filters to further narrow down the list. So I recall there were a few server errors showing up in the dashboard view. How can I see them? What I can do is to add a new field in the search section to filter the view for the server errors in specific. So I'm going to select Add Fields, scroll down, and select the server errors. Now I have a new field for server errors. And this will search for the number of server errors per instance. So I'm going to put the number 0 here and redo the search. Now I see 3 entries that are having internal server errors. I'm going to click the camera icon to see the replay data. And this will open an external window. So here you can see the request headers and response header information, also the response content. And you can set up content notification alerts against this information. So you can configure to search for a specific text within the headers or the content. So for example, you can search for the string internal server error. And when it is detected, you can configure to send an alert message to you. And this is raw HTML, but you can also see the rendered HTML by clicking the replay view. So this is the page that was actually shown to the user. Going back, close the external window. So I could see the HTTP level details. Next, I want to do is to see the thread level information. So I'm going to expand the first row and click the icon in the info section. And what this allows you to do is to click out to Java Workload Explorer page. So I can see one filter added to this page, and I know this is the execution context ID, which was passed on by RUEI in order to show the relevant data. Let me adjust the time range to 2 hours. And here you go. So this is the JVM information for the thread that ended up in a server error. So I can see by the color, which is purple, that was waiting for the network resource. Next, I want to see what method that was invoked. So I can do this by clicking the method tab in the toolbar. And here is the method information that is related to the server error we just saw. And I can further see the constant information to see which file the method resides. I'm going to select action, view code tree. I also want to see the line number, so click this as well. Scroll down. And here shows the file name and line number information of that method. Okay, so that was Java Workload Explorer, which is integrated with RUEI and provides diagnostic information. So I'm going back to the RUEI page. So we are back in the RUEI dashboard page. Next, I would like to do is to see the incidents. As mentioned, KPI metrics are the alerting mechanism in RUEI, and you can configure to set thresholds to them, and you can generate EM events out of them. So the incident section at the upper left side of the screen, I have two warning incidents created for this performance category. And this is because I have set two of the KPIs to raise warning alerts upon crossing the thresholds. So I can click the number, and this will bring me to open the incident page in Enterprise Manager for this particular application. And here I have two incidents raised, one for P95 and another for page load time. And I can see the details of each of them by selecting the row. And let me open this in the separate window to see the incident details. So in this incident, the KPI type is real user. KPI name is search page where load time greater than 6 seconds, and entity type is RUEI application. And the incident was created because I have an incident rule configured for doing so. What that means is that you can use Enterprise Manager's standard monitoring framework features to send you email notifications. You can also configure to run corrective actions or forward the event to the third-party systems. So based on this information, you can create a ticket in ServiceNow, for example. Let me go back to the RUEI dashboard page by the history menu. Where's your application? Okay, so next I would like to see is the user flow. So this is a user flow homepage, and the user flow is a relation of several different web pages that consist of a specific web transaction. So in this example, there are 5 steps. The first of all, search the product, then view the product and add the product to the cart, check out and purchase, then log out the application. So 5 steps total. And this is a flow that I would like my customers to complete. But as a reality, customer may not find products that are interesting to them, or they may experience network issues or page load issues. So those cases, they will not complete the flow and leave the site. So this page tells you the overview of the user flow for the specific duration of the time. So the graph at the upper side of the screen represents the trend of the user behaviors. So the blue line is the average number of visitors, and green bars are completed users, and red and orange bars are aborted or stopped user flows. The graph in this page shows a stable load, which means it's having a similar amount of completed flows and also the uncompleted flows during the time. So from here, nothing unusual you can see just looking at the graph. In the middle of the page, there is a section which is called the step name, and I can see how many of the visitors completed the flow, which is 645, and how many of them left without buying anything. And if they left the website, I can also see which page they left. So most users left the flow at the second step. So this implies many visitors did not find the product that they wanted to purchase. And at the third step, at the to cart step, I see 18 of them left the flow. So they did add a product to the cart, but they did not go to the next step to purchase. Also, 17 of them were having some violations. So I want to see what's going on here. And the table view at the lower side of the screen shows the details of the each user access the page. So in this example, if I click the link of the first row, it opens an external window with session details. So this user started with wine search page, then wine view page, and went to the wine add to cart page, but aborted the page load before the page load completed. That is understandable in this case because it looks like it took 14 seconds and that was still loading the page. So basically the user left the page because the page load was too slow. From here, you can see the HTTP level details or click out to see the Java Workload Explorer page as we already seen earlier in this session. And lastly, I would like to show you a standalone version of RUEI. So RUEI has two user interfaces. One is the EM version that you saw in this demo. Another is the standalone version, which is showing in this screen. So this is a dashboard page showing the same information from the EM version with slightly different look and feel. So what I have here in upper left side is a funnel view of the user flow. This intuitively explains what percentage of the users moved to the next step. So it started with 100% and 96% move to the view page. So it means we lost 4% of the users at this step. And that was actually 41 users out of 1,051 users, which is the total number of visitors during the time. And 71% moved to the third step, and 69% moved to the fourth step. And it was the 67% of the total users who completed the flow during the time. This is the end of the recording of the product demonstration of Oracle RUEI User Experience Insight. Thank you for watching.